Out of their life, miss.
What happened?
Tunnels collapsing because of these awful roots, like I told you before, miss. If only the tunnels had better supports. Oh, the sticks aren't really enough.
How about some sticky sticks? Would they do any better?
This could be it. Do you maybe know someone who knows someone who could fetch me these?
Well, if we keep this between you and me...
It's like it never happened, miss. I'd wink, but you wouldn't notice, which is why I'm telling you this.
It really was Levitsa.
Ready?
Baba. What did she do to the poor girl?
getting any easier.
Does a little hunt tickle your fancy, princess?
I guess we don't have a choice.
We? You don't. Follow her.
May Perun always walk with you. Such a great inspiration. A paragon of virtues. I wish I was more like her. May Perun always walk with you.
Levers of life keep on spinning my thread. Slivitsa. We never got along.
And you probably never will. The Babox. Remember? Out.
beginning of the summer, during the shortest night of the year, the youth partakes in traditional celebrations of Midsummer Night. Before the curfew had been set up, the young would roam the forest freely. As the flower crowns drifted away, so seemed the innocence of their childhood. But let's start from the beginning. An eternal battle between Perun and Veles, the God Brothers, has resulted in the creation of... Wait, brothers. Wasn't it a tale about sisters? Let me just... Oh yes, that's more like it. Back to the sisters, or at least one of them. Yaga and Slavica never got along. Things have only gotten worse since Volko went missing a year earlier.
Do you think Baba's really back? And that she snatched Volko? But you are not scared of Baba. Almost like you knew nothing here could harm you.
I don't know what you mean.
Sure you don't.
When the flower crowns were ready, each girl set hers on the water. Yaga was not in it for tradition's sake. She had something to prove. However, as her crown was slowly getting closer to the boys, an alarming realization came. If he picks it up, he'll approach her.
Is it yours, Yaga?
Her fears came true. It actually was Dragoi. Amid an awkward silence, Yaga struggled to avoid what she secretly sought.
It's my sister's.
She spat out finally. Another thing on her failure resume.
Zora's? Are you sure?
And as always, Zora came to the rescue.
Of course it's mine. We are now bound by it. So tonight, we're looking for the femme flower together. Are you coming, Yaga?
Wait. Are all three of us going?
Oh, would you rather go alone and let Baba chew the flesh off your bones?
They walked and walked and... I always keep walking. But you already know that. Soon enough, Yaga left Zora and Dragoi behind. She decided to wait for them to catch up. But someone else did instead. You can probably guess who, can you?
Well, well. A little ugly bird lost its way in the forest. Or perhaps you've got your nest nearby. The name Gordana, does it ring any bells? You don't think I believe you and Zora are orphans of some deceased relative? Or that it's a coincidence that Volko went missing right after you two had a fight?
He could have lost his way. Or had an accident. Or maybe Baba.
Baba. Yaga, please. I'm too old for fairy tales. What did you do to him? Stay down until you're ready to talk.
Now, Yaga, this is your moment.
My, my. Look who hits the rock bottom. Again, and again, and again, and again.
What do you want me to?
It's time for you to hatch. Or rot here. Forever.